Adnan, first of all, a warm welcome to Glitz Vision USA. It's
Hello.
been hi. It's been a really a long time. So tell me, how are you? I mean, fans wanted to ask, that how is Adnan doing? They have been saying that, thoda apne social media interactions kam kar diya. So just wanted to start, with how are you doing? Just that simple question.
I'm right now. I'm being super weird and super emotional because I'm talking to you.
Okay.
Because you remind me of my show and you remind me of that time and it's really cool. Like I'm like, why am I smiling like a retard? She's telling me, how are you? So I looking at you and it's nice to be in touch with you. This way I get to relive some of those memories. So I've been good per se, but
okay. So Adnan, tell me, since the show ended and, obviously then pandemic, we are still dealing with that. And tell me how it has been for you. Like it has been difficult for everybody, but aapne apna samay kaise bitaya and how has been the pandemic for you?
I don't think it's been difficult for me. I think as a matter, I know I'm one of the few lucky ones, blessed ones who didn't suffer at all by the grace of God and by people's prayers. I was in a position to actually give back to society. And whenever you do selfless, whenever you're selfless, right? Whenever you do give acts, whenever you do acts for other people, purely for other people, the feeling that you get is something that I haven't felt joy, like it's nice to be there for people because the whole world was there for me for this time. So having said that, lockdown was actually a very, how do I say this? I think it recharged my soul. Yeah. I got time for myself. I got time for my family. I, as a matter of fact, picked up my phone and called up all my childhood friends who I haven't spoken to in 10 years, So, for me, it wasn't at all, difficult. It wasn't bad at all. It was one of the best experiences of my life. I know it's sounding wrong because a lot of people have lost their lives and everything, but personally to me, I use this time to the best of my ability. I said, I'm not getting this time again. Okay, so I'll tell you something. Something very weird about me is that, okay, so I love train journeys, long distance train journeys. You want to know why? It's the weirdest reason on the planet. But I love train journeys because I get to do nothing. You understand what I mean? Mm-hmm. Because I can't go to the gym. I can't write. I can't read. Like reading a little bit, but I don't have to do anything because so I love that nothingness ka period, like just sit back and relax because every day I'm rushing about so much and bustling about so much. So merely ye time when I would get out and do nothing. Shit, I was like, wow, man. When was the last time I did nothing? So for me, it was a very, recharge my batteries. My soul felt better. I felt better. And I got a break that I felt I needed. So it was good for me.
Right. But this pandemic, it impacted a lot of industry. Entertainment industry was also one industry which was hugely impacted. And a lot of actors, producers, they came, in front of the camera and they told them, that this industry became a really difficult place to survive. So, you are a part of this industry and, a lot of actors actually rethink about, their decision, of being an actor. It has happened with a lot of people. What were your thoughts, when the industry was hit, when the pandemic, the shootings were stalled? So what were your thoughts as an actor?
So I just thought that, okay, I've got a break. I don't know how long, but let's use this time to the best of my ability. I feel everybody like, okay, as an actor, I know where my weaknesses lie. All right. And I know grounds that I can improve on without outside help. Like I don't need a teacher or I don't need to be doing it practically, So I personally took it upon myself to use that time for something. I'll not lie. It was very difficult, extremely difficult because there was no supervision. There was no routines to keep. There was no deadlines to match. So, the lack of authority or the lack of like an ultimatum kind of made me slightly lazier than I am normally. But I used that time to the best of my ability. Okay, I'll give you an example. I gamed. I used to be a gamer back in Dubai. When I was a kid, I was a decent gamer. Like I've gone for all these shows and everything. But in this award function, in this lockdown, I got time to do that. Now, that's not purely this thing. I feel gaming keeps your mind active. I got to read a lot more than I normally would. I got to watch movies, rewatch movies that I've seen 20 years ago. The thing is, with life, we've become so, we're bustling about so much. I rarely ever rewatch movies, like Lord of the Rings, my favorite. I love that goddamn movie. I love that movie itself. Anyways, yeah, sorry. I get too excited. So I got time to rewatch that thing and that fire come back. That fire was lit again. Like, why am I doing all of this? So I'll be honest with you. Not to say what people went through, because I understand people didn't have money to eat food. People didn't have money to pay rent. People didn't, their businesses shut down. So people were very different. But again, as I was blessed and I was lucky, I took it upon myself to use that time to the best of my ability. There's no excuse not to work, you know. So I tried my best.
Mm-hmm. And how much did you miss your show, you know, during all this period? Because you've been really busy with your show and Daily Soaps, we all know, you know, how busy it keeps you. So how much did you miss that show? And especially, in the, you know, in the situation when you're most of the time you were alone by yourself. So how much did you miss the show?
More than I thought I would. Much more than I thought I would. I'm not someone who's sentimental in that way. But yeah, that show was something... I realized after leaving it, it was in a very aesthetic sense. I think it was very, it was like my mother, like my father, like a guidance, like a friend, like a brother, like a sister, like everything to me. That show was everything. And I didn't realize that until I left, right? So when I left, and yeah, the lockdown happened, and then I missed the team, the creation, the art. I missed it, all of it. Yeah.
Weird. Right. Okay. And of course, you know, fans, you know, they really want to know, you know, what are the upcoming projects you are and where they can see you next. So anything which you can say, it's anything that's in the pipeline.
The craziest thing on the planet is today. Aaj hum log interview kare. Today, mera gana release hua T-Series. So I'm super happy. Okay. I'm controlling myself right now. I'm not sure. That's right. So that song released, and another song is going to release from T-Series itself in some time. And I've done a short, which unfortunately is doing the film circles. But unfortunately, why? Because of the corona ki wajah se, toh things have slowed down slightly. So because of that, my short movies slowed down as well. And I'm currently working on a personal project. Now, this personal project, Kinnari, is the weirdest thing on the planet. Why? Because I'm kind of like, dreaming right now, you know, like I don't want to say gambling. The word gamble is a wrong definition of what I'm going through, but I'm basically working on a personal project which is very close to me, and let's see, it's coming along well.
Right. Okay.
I don't want to talk too much about it right now. Just tell
you that. I understand. Okay. On this note, of course, you know, fans have sent a lot of questions for you, which they wanted, you know, for us to ask you. So, jitna bhi ho sake, I'll try. Okay. So, the first question is that the question is from Naveen, and the question is, you know, we all know that he follows a very strict regime. Okay. So, from when he is following this, is this a childhood habit or it has been developed later?
Excuse me. No. It's not a childhood habit. As a matter of fact, I developed this over the course of me moving here. And that's not immediately, because this is good advice for people. If anyone's trying to discipline their lives to a larger extent, I feel that it's all, it's a habit. Like every single day you add on to that habit. It's not like I woke up one day and I said, okay, I'm going to work out for 3 hours. I'm only going to eat this. I'm only going to do that. I'm going to write every day. No, I got to do, no, none of that. So this schedule of mine, this discipline of mine has been accrued over, acquired over at least a good 2 years. When I moved here, 2 years it took for me to get the ball rolling. And I'm still getting the ball rolling. I'm still trying to improve. There is an aspect of my discipline, Kinnari, which is driving me nuts. I get so irritated because this is the one thing I can't fix. So basically, I wake up late.
Okay.
I've been waking up late since I was a kid. Like when I was in Dubai, I used to wake up really late. I used to sleep at 5-6 in the morning and wake up late. Yeah, the giant area. And it's driving me nuts because I'm super disciplined. I'm super, like everything is so down to time. And I have to do my gym. I have to do my writing. I have to spend time with family. I have to read. I have to learn. I have to write. All of that has to happen. But Kinnari, 12 baje ke baad. 12 से पहले कुछ नहीं होता. I don't know why, man. So stupid. Anyways, I'll fix it. But that's my one thing that I'm trying to work with. So you see, I've got like 12 hours of a day nailed. Like I really feel that I'm using my time semi-efficiently. But this morning wala thing, so it's a habit. Like I'm going to fix that too, inshallah.
Right. So, right. Okay. Second question is, ask him to say one of his shayaris. Do you remember anything?
Yeah, I do. I've written so many. The last 2-3 was so bad. I got so irritated with myself. Like Muzabani, mujhe ek do yaad hai. Ek to logo ko pata hai jo maine show mein use kiya tha. Do maine show mein use kiye the. Ek maine banaya tha. Maine ye bola. But this is the only one I remember by heart, so I'll share it with you. Okay, so it goes like, I am weird, dude. Because in my head, these shairis are amazing. Like in my head, I'm writing Rumi-esque things, right? Okay, anyways, okay, let's do this. So, dosti mein chal rahi thi behas, mohabbat karne walo ka. Dosti mein chal rahi thi behas, mohabbat karne walo ka. To ek dost ne poochta apne dosto se ke, इम्तिहान है इश्क का पहला सवाल, जब वो नजरों के सामने हो तो कैसा लगता है? तो एक दोस्त ने कहा, हाँ, सोच के कहा, जिंदगी के गम की आवाज नहीं सुनाई देती. क्या? जिंदगी के गम की आवाज नहीं सुनाई देती. दूसरे दोस्त ने कहा, वहां पर इससे बेहतर मैं कुछ बताता हूं. तो क्या सेड, इस सांस से आखिरी सांस तक सिर्फ उसी को देखता रहूं. मतलब जब वो नजरों के सामने हो तो इस सांस से आखिरी सांस तक सिर्फ उसी को देखता रहूं. तो तीसरा दोस्त पीछे जो बैठा था बोला, आप दोनों ने बहुत अच्छा कहा है पर गलत. तो ये लोग पलट के बोलते, गलत गलत कैसे? बोलते, इम्तिहान है इश्क का है ही एक सवाल, जब वो नजरों के सामने ना हो तब पूछना उसके दिल का हाल. You understand?
This is very great. This is very deep and it is very
liked
great.
It? Really.
Yeah, you really liked it. Okay. Yeah, that was really good. Okay. Now, the third question is, okay. In one of his IG live, he said he feels jealous of Zabir. Why so? That's the question.
Ye kisne pucha hai? ये कौन है ऐसा सवाल पूछा? मेरे को नाम बताओ किसने पूछा ये सवाल.
निवीन दास ज़बीर. I said
I'm jealous of Zabir. I'll honestly tell you, I don't know in what context. But maybe, okay, I think I remember now. So I'll tell you what I missed about that couple. I feel they loved equally. Like I feel I have loved people in my life as much as Kabir loved Zara. But resolution jo log ki ladaiyan ka bahut jaldi ho jata tha. Ego was there. They were very humane in their emotions. They had ego, they had revenge, anger, all of that. But their love would always supersede these emotions. At the end of the day, the love would always supersede these emotions. But I feel in real life, unfortunately, we're kind of victims to egos sometimes, which is very stupid. I feel we are victim to society, to our parents, our friends, what they think, what they say. So Zabir was lucky that way. They were so, their love, or they, I'm not sure who, but I felt it was their love, was so strong that it superseded all these nonsensical things that are leading to relationships not lasting today, which is ego, jealousy, cheating on people, and all of these stupid, silly things, right? So I used to be jealous of that. Yeah, like, it's magical. Their love is magical. So that was the jealous part.
Okay. Second question is, please ask him about the script that he wrote, and is it already finished?
No, it's not already finished, but I'm not going to talk about it right now because, not going to talk about it.
Okay. Okay. Finished. Okay, not an issue. Okay, the second question is, so there's actually a lot of question about your script. So moving on. Okay, the second, yeah, the second question is, you know, if Ishq Subhanallah, because a lot of, especially ZTV shows are made into web series. So the question is, you know, if Ishq Subhanallah is ever made into a web series, will he be interested in doing that? So that's the question.
100%. I would love to.
Right, okay. The third question is, just ask him to stay in touch with his fans. We know he's super busy. Request him to take out some time. That's the complaint or a question, I don't know, but I'm just asking.
I'm going after this live. What I normally do is, I've been really busy and I've been avoiding social media for a while. But what I'm going to do, what I was planning to do was before, normally what I do is before every live interview, I spend 10-15 minutes with them alone. You know, like I go and I message you, I'm going live. What I do is I just spend time with them and give them some, like, answer their questions firsthand, because I know these guys have, it's weird. They supported me, so me and Isha and the show so much. Me too, like, they supported me so much. And I'm not used to this. I still don't understand it. Like, in my head, when I tell a friend, like, if me and my best friend are sitting and he's like, yeah, bro, your fans messaged me. And we both look at each other and we're like, what? Like, fans? And when did I get fans? Like, it's still crazy for me, dude. It's still weird for me. You know, fans. So I never understood why, but itna support ke. They recently, 3 days ago, they went trending on Ishq Subhanallah for a hashtag of Ishq Subhanallah 3 days ago on Twitter. That's crazy. The show ended like 7-8 months ago. These people are legit. The show connected with them, I felt somewhere. Like these characters, the love, something connected with them so much that, yeah, it's beautiful, man. So I'll spend some time with these guys.
Okay, second question, I ask him about when is he going to meet Isha and why they are not, meeting so often. That's the fan's question.
Because she's extremely busy and I am busy too. And she keeps flying out. I keep flying out. I was in Dubai for 2 months before that. She was in Bhopal. Phir corona chal raha hai. Bhai, mujhe corona nahi chahiye. Main open. No, I'm kidding. No. She doesn't have anything. And she's one of the nicest people. She's actually tried, but I've tried too. But hum log dono itne busy, she's been very busy. But we're planning on. Yeah.
Okay. This is an interesting question. If there's ever, of all the movies which has been made, if there is one movie which you think you and Isha can ace that character or, that jodi, what would be that one romantic film?
I think we would kill Mr. and Mrs. Smith. Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie, and I think we would kill Rockstar.
Rockstar, great.
I think we would murder it, and I think we would murder Barfi also.
Right, all amazing. I think films, we.
No, you know
characters.
What? Can I tell you something? I think me and her, we tuned together really well. So I sincerely believe you give us anything, we can make it better. Not being cocky. No disrespect to any other actor, but I genuinely feel that. It was a magical match. Like, we tuned so well together.
Great. Okay, please ask him about his vacation in Dubai. And is there any desire to settle down there again?
No desire at all to settle down there. Because I love what I do. And India allows me to do what I love, basically. So, no, I don't want to settle down there. My vacation was lovely. But it was a bit long for me. 2 months of not doing work is... weird, and I got like I didn't know what, because 7 years of being so disciplined and routine and work, and then all of a sudden I got free time where I'm just sitting and doing nothing. This doing nothing word was never in my dictionary, so it was nice.
Right.
You know what the best thing was? I got to meet friends, dude. This is something so weird, because I had forgotten. I was so busy and caught up with everything that I had forgotten what friends feel like. Like, really, sincerely, I'm telling you, I had forgotten what it felt like to be around friends. I went to Dubai and, for example, like a friend would call me and be like, bro, let's hang out and let's go here and there. I'm like, yeah, sure. He's like, all right, I'll be at your place in 10. And now this small thing, I'll be at your place. I didn't ask him. I didn't tell him to come pick me up. But ek friend hone ke naate, he knows bachpan mein, he's always dropped me and picked me up. So without me asking, he's downstairs. And I just love that, like, without asking friends, like, yeah, it was very, dude, I got super weird the first 4 days. I got so weird the first 4 days when I went to Dubai. people couldn't understand what was going on, but I'll tell you what was going on. I got so emotional because I'm not used to getting so much love at one time. In a physical sense, in the sense that when I went for a dinner, I went for a family dinner. And so I went from a family dinner and everyone's talking to me and everyone's loving me and everyone's like nice. And I had forgotten this feeling because for 7 years, I never left. I never left. I went to Dubai last for like 4 years ago for 7 days. Never spent time with family. I haven't gone for any of my friends' weddings. I haven't, like, I cut it all out. So when I went back and suddenly people are like putting food for me and on my plate, I was like, no, eat. I'm like, thank you, man. Thank you. Like, Jesus. Like, I learned some lessons that your friends and family are, dreams are dreams, but yeah, you need to give a lot, certain time, a little time for friends and family, you know? Yeah.
So the next question is, you know, till the time you started your career in this industry, okay, and till now, what has been the best experience and worst experience till now?
I think worst had to be true. The one time I got fired from Zee Sinistar ki coach, and I passed like four or five rounds, and then I got let go. And I was in that bus alone. I remember, Dur tha kahin par tha, Rajkumar Studio or something like that. And I was coming back. It was a 2-hour journey in the bus. And I was just so low. I was so low. Like, yeah. Because I had no, I just didn't know how I was going to do it and what. And I was failing. And the second low thing for me, like really bad, was, screw that shit. I don't want to talk about bad. I'll tell you the good stuff. So the good stuff, today, one of those days, today, my song came out. Okay. I was dreaming about this for a very, very long time. Another happy thing for me was, okay, this is really weird. Nothing came out of it. Like, it didn't finalize, but when I did, I kind of sold my script a few years ago, right? Before I started the show. And they got to a point where they made me hire a lawyer. The production house made me hire my own lawyer to protect my rights for the script. And we had this meeting on call, right? Just this meeting on call where I hired my own lawyer to protect my rights for my literary acquisition agreement and all of that. Like, I was like, whoa, bro, where am I, man? Like, the guy from Dubai who didn't know anybody has like a lawyer right now. And like, you know, we're discussing points on my script, like of making it a film and all that. It didn't get finalized, but just that feeling, like, you know, I was like, wow, man, I did this, man. Right, like right. You know, this is happening. So that was really cool. When I got the best debutant award, I forgot what function it was, but I got the best debutant award. And yeah, that really made my day. That really, really made my day.
Right. Okay. Okay. And then last questions I'm taking. Tell me one thing, you know, that, you know, whether it's personal or professional, like everyone has their own ups and downs. Okay. What is the one thing which keeps you motivated, especially, you know, you are living away from your family, you're all alone in the city. Of course you have friends, but you're still living away from your family. So what's the one thing which keeps you motivating if there is any down in your life?
I have probably figured out, I figured out two things. I could say that's my motivation. One is that I love films. I love almost all aspects of films, of the acting part, the editing, all of it. I know, like, I've realized that I love it. That's one proper realization. The second thing what I've realized is that I have this theory that I've coined, which is the donkey theory. The donkey theory basically signifies that a donkey, when it has to climb up a mountain, it's going to do it really slow. It's not the fastest animal up there. It's going to take its own time. It's probably not going to do it in the most efficient way. It's probably not going to do it in the most beautiful way. It's probably not going to do it in the most, it's the way it's going to go about climbing the top of the mountain is going to probably be ridiculous. It's going to be ridiculed and it's going to be laughed at. That's a donkey, right? Like, it's going to be laughed at and it's going to feel bad. It's got emotions. But you know what? A donkey just keeps going. It'll just keep going. Slow, fast, funny, bad, good, whatever. It will keep going. It'll just keep going. And one day or the other, you'll see the donkeys on top of the mountain. So I have that theory, like, I don't have contacts here. I never did. And honestly, I'll tell you, I'm not very, I wouldn't want to use the word cunning because negative or other, but I don't think I'm very smart in that sense. Like I can't see like, oh, I should be, you know, networking. Like I haven't paid any attention to networking. That's something so silly and so stupid. I didn't have contacts. My talent in acting was a skill that I'm developing. It's not, I'm not naturally talented. I'm not naturally gifted. I know this. You know, so the way I go about it is I'll fall, I'll make mistakes. I know that, but I just keep going. That's how I motivate myself. Like, I know I just have to keep going. I can't stop.
Right. Okay. One character, you know, there's always a wish list for every actor that, you know, someday I'll play a character like this. So is there any wish list on your?
I always want to do, so action, definitely. I would love to be like a John Wick. I would love fight movies. That's something I really want to do. And rock star. I don't know why. I don't know why. Nothing. Ranbir Kapoor did a phenomenal job. I probably can't even touch that performance. Mine would be different in my own way. But I really want to do that. Yeah.
Right. Okay, the last question which we are going to take, we don't know whether you're going to like it or not, but the question is there any plans of marriage in Adnan's wish list in the coming future?
Every day my mind changes. Every day my decision changes. Every day I think I should get married and settle down. And every day I say no, but I have to follow my dream. Itna kuch karna hai. But nahi yaar, shaadi kar lete hain. Budda ho raha hun. But nahi yaar. Sapne pure kar. So it's an ongoing battle. Yeah. I don't know. Yeah. But my heart is still linked towards getting married because I think it's the right thing to do. You know? Yeah.
Right. Okay. And on this note, thank you so much, Adnan, for, you know, answering all the lovely questions. And yeah, jate, you know, fans ko, Glitz Vision ke viewers ko, kuch bhi kehna chahenge related to your projects or, you know, anything which you want to say fans, what would be that?
Thank you guys. As always, thank you so much for still supporting, still loving, still messaging, still checking up, still sending gifts. Still, I don't know why you guys are like that, but thank you for just being.
Thank you so much, Adnan, and all the best for every projects and for everything in your life. Thank you so much.
Thank you, so sweet of you, Kinali. Bye bye. See you.
Bye. Take care. Bye. Bye.
Hi, this is Adnan Khan.
And this is Isha Singh.
And you're watching us both on
Glitz Vision
USA.
Yeah.
Thank you.